talks about so there are three keywords, which is talent, marketplace, and it's a design or iterative design, right? So marketplace, just to set the overall context, right? Marketplace is a place where we match demand and supply, and we are talking about talent marketplace, which largely we are talking about an organization's talent marketplace, which is internal. So we will try to focus our debate around that, that, okay, what is internal talent marketplace? What's the design looks like and how things have changed, right? Because everybody is only talking about how the work or the workplace or the workforce has changed in last couple of or more than a year now with the pandemic that we have gotten, right?
And so I would like to start, you know, by quoting someone very famous that we all are very familiar with, Mr. Narayan Murthy. Right? He once said that our assets walk out of the door each evening and we have to make sure that they come back the next morning. Right? So I feel an organization is not made up of roles and designations, but what defines an organization are its people. So when we take a look at an organization today, it's all about catering to their needs. We as a generation, we have changed and evolved over years. So right now you're going to find, you'll find all kinds of generations in an organization, from Xennials to Millennials to Gen X and Boomers. Everyone thinks very, very differently and get a different perspective to the table. So that's why it is very essential to ensure that you're providing growth to all the people that make up an organization. You have to give them the right platforms. You have to upskill them. You have to give them the right opportunities so that they can keep growing within an organization. Because if you kind of think about it, people outgrow roles, but we don't want them to outgrow the organization.
The way the pandemic has hit us, which was unplanned, unprecedented, and I think nobody expected it, I think the need for a marketplace has gone up now. And I think a lot of organizations are thinking now, since we're all working virtually, it has broken down a lot of myths, and it has also broken down a lot of barriers. And the need to have smaller teams and the team to be having the right skill at the right place, and to bring talent, supply of talent and demand to map and match. It's also broken down a lot of myths around manager owning the talent, vis-a-vis manager empowering the talent and enabling the talent to work basis their skills and basis the talent which they bring on the table. I think some of the design perspective, if I look at it, I think the core is, why are we doing it? I think the organizations, we all have to answer the question of what is the purpose of doing that? And a lot of times, if you spend enough time as to what is the purpose, is the purpose to drive some high impact projects, then how will you measure that? And I think the measures are very important. Rather than being in a rush to deploy a certain initiative because the whole world is doing it, I think that is not the right way of doing it. The right way is that, what is the purpose? What problem is it going to solve for my organization? What metrics are we going to put in there? And once you have that in place, I think we need to have steps required to meet that risk, to actually meet the entire core purpose as to why we are doing it. So once we have the steps planned out, and it has to be like a program, who will do this? A lot of time we say CHRO of the company will drive that. But I've also seen some organizations which also has actually put up an entire task force around it. So it also depends on whether we have the purpose and we have the intent behind that to drive it effectively. I think third and fourth is going to be around the program, that we need to enable the policies, we need to enable our processes around it to actually support that kind of a mechanism. And the fourth is that we must deploy technology. How can we leverage technology around it to be able to deploy all these solutions and the purpose of why we are doing it?
There are three essential elements when we talk of an organization's workforce strategy, Sachin. To my mind, three things come almost inverted, inadvertently. The first one is, our org structures and org designs. I think that's very, very crucial to any organizations or workplaces talent strategy. The second element is the employment models. And I say that because it's going to change in the next 5 years like it has never changed before. I mean, we are seeing that happening in countries like US and UK. We're not seeing a lot of that happening in India, but we're hearing a lot of gig, but we're not seeing that gig aspect translating on ground. But I think it's going to happen. It's going to happen sooner than later because it's something that we can't run away from. And the third element of the entire workforce strategy is really the roles and the skills that the organizations need to stay relevant and to achieve what they aspire to achieve. So for me, these are the three broad buckets: org structures and designs, employment models, and various roles and skills that are needed at organizations today.